Give you the status of the group report, number four. The groups that submitted their reports today morning is group five, group three, group seven, group six, and group eight. Missing is group two. Who is the leader of group two?
Sir, nasend na po.
Okay. Kailan mo sinend, Alexander?
10:59.
Ngayon lang.
Bago mag-class.
Ah, kasi send mo lang.
Oo.
Ah, okay, so group two. Okay. Mamaya ko na titignan yung sa email. Okay, so that means all the groups submitted. So we have already finished the topic on lesson on impulse and momentum. That's all. Okay. Okay. this is to remind the class again that the midterm test or exam will be today at tonight at starting 7 o'clock. So you are aware of that already. And I hope you already prepared the midterm answer sheet to avoid the delaying of because it will contribute to time delay in getting the exam if you have no ready answer sheet. Lalagay lang sa short band paper yung heading kagaya dun sa quiz number. Papalitan doon lang sa instead of quiz number 2, lalagay midterm exam. Yun lang naman eh. So that when you take the exam at 7 o'clock, basahin nyo na lang yung instruction, then go to the questions. Also, ready ang file name doon sa test paper. Okay. Yung test paper ang lalagyan ng file name. Lalagay lang doon na DCBET 2-1 midterm, then yung family na yun. I'm glad in the group homework number 4 yung file name doon sa report. So very easy. So tingnan ko lang doon sa kone sa file eh, alam kong nag-submit na lahat ng group. Okay. That is very easy identification. Okay. So, people, next lesson, which I already forwarded to the class earlier. Did you receive this lesson on fluid statics? Na-receive niyo ba yon?
Yes, po.
Okay. So I hope you started reading those already, and only 4 pages. Okay. So that you have idea, ito pala ang fluid mechanics, fluid statics. Okay. So if there is no question with regards to the test, the midterm today evening, 7 o'clock, we will proceed directly to the new lesson. Okay. So I'm this is this class is members and only 41 joined as of now. So 15 are missing. Anyway, I hope they will join later. So we will start the new lesson. I will just attach the file. Start okay, window. Okay, this is the new lesson. I will start now. Please listen. Okay, makinig lang, and I have always requesting you, if you did not understand, you ask, or I can repeat, so that you can fully understand the subject matter, okay? So no one is okay, still a board though. Okay, fluid statics. This term statics this term because we used that earlier in force and motion. What did we use this is a term started? Friction, static friction or coefficient of static friction. So static means at rest, stationary. Okay, or stop or not moving. So these are the this is the meaning of static. Fluid. So later we will since we this is the a new term, you can you will understand later. So the first topic that we will discuss is already familiar to all of you. You have covered in your chemistry for engineers, but it is best this only review, but it is best step of this three state of matters. Okay, ordinary matter can be found in any one of the three, namely solid, liquid or gas, because matter is defined as anything that occupies, they have mass, they have weight. So all of these three, solid, liquid and gas, occupy space. Yes, mass, it is weight. Okay. From one point of view, solids and liquids are classified since they have certain properties in common, like they are both relatively incompressible, so that their volumes can hardly be changed. Gases, on the other hand, are easily compressible. Okay, this statement say liquid are both relatively incompressible, okay? Because their volume will not change. Okay. Solid, if you try to compress solid, it may be a that compression is negligible, especially in liquid. Okay. Liquids cannot be compressed. If you try to compress the liquid, okay, the container dilapidated if it is a metal. So the liquid will just go out. That's why it is incompressible, cannot be compressed. But gases, okay, on the other hand, are easy. Gas can be compressed. There are two forms of compression. We have the positive compression, expansion, yun, lalaki ang size. We have the negative compression, liliit naman yung size. Iko-compress niya. Okay. So that is difference between gases and solid and liquid as far as compressibility is concerned. Okay. From a different point of view, gases and liquids are grouped together as fluid, since they can flow. Gases expand in them, whereas liquids settle at the bottom of the container where they are placed and take its shape. Solid does not have this property. This statement says gas and liquid are grouped together. So fluid ngayon, pwedeng gas, pwedeng liquid. Bakit? Because of their similar, magkapareho ang kanilang characteristic. Ano yung mga characteristic na yon? Flow characteristic. Okay. Also, gases can flow. So both are classified as fluid. Example, liquid, like such as water. Water is liquid. Oil is liquid. Gasoline is liquid. Okay. So if we take, okay, if you put the water in a pipe, in the case of you are using in your residence at home, okay, if you open the water valve, water flow. So liquid can flow. Gas also. Okay. For example, if you are cooking food, okay, if you open the bulb of the cooking or gasol, so Fuel gas is flowing a hose and directly to the gas tube, so you can cook your. So gas or fuel gas flow, okay. That is regarding flow casting. Another characteristic of gases and liquid that are the same or similar is shape. So flow, characteristic of flow, to a flow, the characteristic regarding the shape. Shape of the liquid can be determined, okay, if the liquid is placed inside a container, okay. You cannot determine or see the shape of the liquid if you will not put inside dinner. For example, water. Water as a liquid, if you put inside a bottle, water follow the shape of the Coca-Cola bottle. Okay. How about gas? The shape of gas also same with the liquid. You cannot determine the shape of the gas if you cannot put inside a gas container. Okay. For example, the cooking gas that I mentioned earlier, okay, that gas is inside the gas tank, the tanke yon. So, the gas, the shape of the gas, or the gas follow the shape of the gas container. So, characteristic of shape is common to both gas and liquid. That's why they are grouped as fluids. Okay. So, in physics, alam na natin na ang gas at liquid ay fluids. Okay. Ang nagpapatunay yung flow characteristics. Characteristic nila at yung shape characteristic. Itsura. Okay. Shape. So, the atoms in a solid have relatively fixed positions in the overall structure. Whereas in the fluid, the atoms can easily move relative to one another. Okay. Once the atoms of the fluid have taken the shape of the container holding them, fluid flow stops and the fluid becomes stationary.
Okay. Sir? So,
yes?
Daw pong hindi pa nakaka-join po, pa-accept daw po sila.
Okay. Okay, therefore, the if the fluid becomes stationary, stand still, or stop, or not moving, fluid is static. And this is the study of properties of fluids at rest. So, ano yung mga properties diniscuss na natin. Flow property, compressibility. Yon mga properties of fluid at rest. Ano ngayon ang mga example ng fluid at rest? Okay. Yung water container, yan, fluid at rest yun. Ano pa? Yung lake. Lake is a body of water where there is no flow. Okay. Walang flow ng water. Hindi kagaya ng river. Ang river yung water flowing. That is yung sea or ocean. Okay. Those are examples of fluids at rest. Okay. Refers to gas and liquid. Yan ang fluid. Okay. Any question, class? In-explain na sa inyo yung prof yung pag doon sa chemistry for engineer. In-explain ba sa inyo ito? Yung states of matter.
Apo, sir.
So, ibig sabihin nun, naintindihan nyo na. Okay. Vance Fernando, in-explain ba sa chemistry niya ito sa inyo?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, the reason why I explain this in detail because we will be using this concept on the next topics, okay? We already understand the meaning of fluid statics, okay? Study of the properties of fluid at rest. The quantities that describe fluid statics are this. First quantity that describe fluid statics is density. One important property of matter in general and of fluids in particular is the density denoted by the Greek letter rho. Okay. A scalar quantity that defined as the ratio of the mass. The density rho is equal to mass divided by volume, that is m over v. The unit of mass is a kilogram. And for the volume is cubic meter, the unit of density is kilogram per cubic meter. Okay. That is in the SI or if you are using the CGS, system of units, meter per gram, volume in cubic centimeter. So the unit is gram per cubic Centimeter. And this formula divided by volume is called mass density. Mass for the density. Density may be expressed also expressed by as height density. Okay. This given or calculated by the using the formula. The weight. The formula can be determined by constant G on both sides of the equation. So, rho G is equal to M over B. Okay, we did not change the equation because G here and G here. Okay. Therefore, rho G is equal to, knowing that the weight W is equal to mass multiplied by okay. And what is this term M times G is weight. Rho G now is equal to W over B, where rho G is the weight density, weight W is the weight, and now this constant G has values 9.8 meters per second squared in the MKS or S unit. Okay. Okay, so rho G is the weight and B is the volume. G, these are the values of G. So due to gravity is equal to 9.8, 2.2 per cent squared. Value of gravitational acceleration. Now, the weight density now, the rho g is equal to weight divided by volume. Bakit naging weight density? Because weight is used. Weight of the object is used. Now, weight density may be expressed in Newton per cubic meter in the SI or dyne per cubic centimeter. So we have two forms of density. Any question, class? Do you have any question?
Wala po, sir.
Okay, we'll continue. Okay. The substance in general depends on environmental factors like temperature. But for liquids and solids, the variation in density is very small. Over a wide range of many factors that to the first approximation we can create always a constant. The density units in the SI system is in kilogram per cubic meter, in CGS it is gram per cubic centimeter. Okay. We have the conversion factor, 1 gram per cubic centimeter equals 10 or 1,000 kilogram per cubic meter. Okay. So 1 gram per cubic centimeter, if you convert and centimeter to meter, you can get this value. So that is as far as density is concerned. Okay. So take note of this conversion. 1 gram per cubic centimeter equals 10 to the cube, or this is actually 1,000. Okay, 1,000 kilogram per cubic. Okay. Next. The second quantity that describes fluid statics is the specific gravity. The specific gravity. Okay, specific gravity tensionless quantity defined as follows. Specific gravity is weight of object in air. That is W A. Okay. So weight of equal volume of water. We have to determine this equal volume of water. Now this is the laboratory formula for specific gravity, because you have to measure the weights. If they are not given, you have to measure them. And what is the instrument used in measuring the weights? So maybe we can use the weight scale or the spring balance or any scale. So, weight of object in air, to determine the weight of the body exposed to the air or exposed to the atmosphere is this. Okay. This is a stone. So to get the mass of this object, you have to put here. You will take note that this object is the atmosphere. Okay. So the reading of this scale maybe is either in grams or kilograms. That's the mass. So to get the weight, WA, you have to equate this that you have obtained in the scale multiplied by acceleration due to gravity. There, MG. That is how to get the weight of object in air. Nasa air yung to, yung object. Na okay. We have to determine first what is this called volume? Water. Okay. Now, to determine this weight of equal volume water, okay, we have to use that there here. This graduated cylinder is almost full of water. Okay. So initially, when the object, the initial reading or volume here, initial volume is V sub O or V sub 1. Kasi ito yung ginamit na subscript. So 1, V sub 1, that is the lowest level of the cylinder here. So once the object is immersed there, level of the liquid now will go up also. Okay. Now, please note that the graduated cylinder is calibrated, or there are divisions here indicating the volume of the liquid. Okay. Actually, the initial volume is this. Wala pa ito. When you put inside, there will be a rise. It will be V sub 2. Now, the unit that are marked here in the graduated system, ml or milliliter. So, there is a conversion factor used in finding the equivalent of ml to cubic centimeter. And we have 1 ml is equal to 1 cubic centimeter. So volume na yan, cubic centimeter. Okay. So we need to get the rise volume, which is the change in the W sub 2 mass, W sub 1. Okay, well, no, the change in volume is equal to V sub 2 minus V sub 1. That is volume when the object is submerged in the graduated cylinder. So what will happen? It will, the level will rise. Okay. So the space here now, until here, is the change in volume. Okay. And equal volume. This volume is equal to this block. Okay. loob ng tubig, aakyat yung level. So, like this, i-separate itong water na ito, put in another cylinder here, and get the mass of the graduated cylinder. So makukuha ang mass dito. Okay. Look at the reading now here. We are interested in the weight of equal volume of water. So hindi kasama yung graduated cylinder. So ang gagawin is the fluid now inside, that is the delta V. Okay. Will be separated. It says may pwedeng ilagay sa ibang container ito so that the graduated cylinder is empty. Pag empty na ito, graduated cylinder, you get also the mass. So therefore, the mass of the water, okay, the mass of the equal volume of water is graduated cylinder plus graduated cylinder with water inside minus the graduated cylinder. That is the mass of the water. Okay. So once the mass of the water determined, you can use the formula of weight of the water is equal to mass of the water times gravitational acceleration g. That is the weight of equal volume of water. Okay. So kapangin and subtract the from the combined weight. So we get the weight of equal volume water. That is the process followed in the laboratory. This formula is used in it's applied the other formula of specific gravity is density of substance divided by density of water. General formula for specific gravity. Density is also of substances can be found in density tables. Okay. Now, the real density of water is used here. Okay. Bakit density of water ang gamit? Thus, okay, because density is equal to for water, ang 1 gram per cubic centimeter, that is the density in the CGS, equals 10 cube kilo per cubic. So again, this is the density of fresh water. Ito. Okay. 1,000 kilogram per cubic meter. Or to prove that, Great. And meter. Ganyan. Okay, so you understand now how to get the weight of the object in the air and the weight of the equal volume. Diana, another nice specific gravity is the relative density. The density of water at kilogram per cubic meter. That is rho r. That means it is relative density. So rho r ito. Rho r. So the weight of object in air over weight of equal volume of water equals density of the substance over density of water. The weight density of any substance now can be determined by applying the formula. Okay. Rho g, that is weight density. Okay. Rho r. So very easy to identify this. Pag sinabing rho density, rho r is relative density, yung r. And rho does the data. Okay. So aside from this formula, g equals w over v, the other formula for rho g, this one, the weight density is the water. So these are the formulas regarding relative density and specific gravity. Question with density and relative density or specific gravity. May tanong ba kayo? Okay. I have already the time now is 11:54. So meron pa tayong 4 minutes. Wait. Saan ba si, sino bang gano'n dito? Emeline Matalog, sa si Emeline. Are you here, Emeline?
Bakit po?
May
bakit
question po kayo?
Wala po.
Wala, okay. Now, sir, my question now is, do you want we have lunch break or continue below?
Lunch break.
I observe we are lang 1 hour. So before we are having the 30 minutes lunch break. Turbo clock, lunch break yun eh. So, anong tinatanong ko sa inyo kung tuloy-tuloy na natin yung 2 hours or ayun? Anong masasabi mo, Emeline?
Wait lang po, sir. At tanong ko po. Lunch break, sir.
Okay, so mag-post muna tayo ng 30 minutes. Kasi 4 minutes na lang. Continue the lecture at 12:30. Okay? Natapos na natin yung dalawang quantities and specific gravity. So, after the lunch break, at 12:30, we will start lecture. Okay, class?